Guys, it is me and my Uber driver, Jan, live from Dallas. Do you want to say anything, Jan?
Nope. Come to Dallas and visit us.
If you are in the Dallas area, she is Ubering in a nice Kia. She'll hook you up with some transportation. I rode the Megabus again. This time, it wasn't as spacious because there were people sitting in my section, but the commute wasn't that bad. Smelled like cigarettes a little bit. That's the only complaint that I have. It took us about 5 hours to get there instead of 4 if I were to drive. But I still saved money because I paid about $28 for a round trip from Little Rock to Dallas. Versus I've probably spent like $40 for gas on Ruby there and back. So I did good. We're waiting for my food. I got me some green beans from Popeyes. And then I'm going to head to my Airbnb. And I'll be sure to show you guys what that looks like. Say bye,
Jay. Bye-bye.
So this is what the outside looks like, guys. It's pretty cute. Driving here, the area was a little rough. But she said that they're rebuilding because it's an old spot. So I guess it's being gentrified. I'm going to go inside and show y'all my first reaction in a second. Let me get my stuff out the trunk and I'll be back. Okay, you guys. This is the moment of truth. Can't let you guys see the code. Going in. Oh. This is pretty nice. The kitchen. Marble counters. Stainless steel house equipment. I'm impressed. Nice little kitchen setting. Rooms in the back. Looks just like the picture. Okay, happy about that. Supplied me with towel and soap. Not a good view, but the bed's fine. Let me see how it... Oh yeah, I can sleep on this. So yeah, you guys, the Airbnb looks great. I'm going to get comfortable and find somewhere to go for Taco Tuesday, and I'll be back. So I have just arrived to the Dallas Comedy House. I'm not sure if we can record, but I'm gonna try to get you guys some funny footage. Hopefully they make me laugh. The next day Chappelle might be in here, you never know. I just wanna show y'all my outfit, really. Cute, cute. I really like it, it's different. You know, you tie it in the back. I'm not sure if the knot goes in the front or the back, but I really like this outfit. And I'll keep you guys posted.
Home to go visit some friends. We're hanging out at a bud's house, and his mom comes in and goes, "Oh my god, it's so good to see you guys. You guys hungry? Tony, you hungry like the bitch called me out?" He's like, "No, Mrs. Johnson, I ate an hour ago." And she goes, "What?"
Hello, you guys. I am reporting live from the Botanical Gardens here in Dallas. Right now, I'm basking in the sun, sun bathing actually, barefoot. It feels really good, like I'm really just gonna lay out in the grass. Today has been very eventful. This morning I woke up around 10, had a long night last night. We went to the comedy show, and then I ended up going to play pool with my Uber driver. He was so cool. Shout out to D-Bone, he might be watching. This morning I got up, you know, I ate a banana, and I was like, you know, I want to do something that's in nature today. And I decided to come here. I thought it was free. It was $15. But it was money well spent. It's really relaxing and calming to be in nature and just be barefoot and relax. I went to this dairy place for lunch called Dairy Ete. I had a root beer float. Bah. Ran right through me because, you know, I don't really eat that stuff anymore, and I had a cheeseburger. I took one of the buns off because it was too much bread. But right now, I'm going to just really enjoy this, you guys. I wanted to show you where I was at. I might get another shot for you later so you can get the view that I'm getting, but it just smells so good out here. I'm going to lay down, actually. Peace up, A-Town. Yeah. Found the perfect place to meditate. Nobody's over here. Won't hear any chattering. I can lay down. I feel like this is like that trail from Forrest Gump when he was talking to that guy in the park. This view is so pretty. Water. Did he guess? I feel like I'm on that one game my nephew plays. What is it called? It's like a blocky environment. And you make your own reality.
Come on, let's go.
So I have just arrived at this bar slash wing place called Gators. I'm waiting for my birthday twin to get here. She said she's slow, so I knew she's gonna be late, but I'm here. It's dry. I'm gonna drink, and I'll report back later. Bye. Okay, you guys, today is the day that I complete the task, the reason why I am here, the career fair. I'm sleepy. I drank a little more than I should have last night, but I'm okay. I'm a champ. I'm going to do well anyway. So I'm about to get ready to go, and I'll be back when it's time. All right, you guys, I'm here. I am early. I'm going to go set up, look over my resume, and get mentally prepared. Outfit, and I'll be back and let you know how things went. Wish me luck. Bye. So I just left a career fair. When I signed in, I saw the list of how many companies were there, and I was like, this is it. It was only like 8 different companies there. I thought it would be like 20, 30 since we're in Dallas, and it was a big area. But I had to remain positive and optimistic. I was like, I'm going to go in there and act like there's 100 different people in there and just, you know, go in there and network and talk and see what they got going on. So I left with the possibility of 4 different careers. And they all gave me their business card. They told me to apply so that I could be called for an interview, and I'm going to get an email from one of the companies. So I can do a personality assessment. So overall, everything went pretty well, and I feel good about it. So what I learned from this experience is every experience, you can learn something from it. I learned not to let the numbers fool you. Like, sometimes small numbers aren't bad numbers. You just gotta be positive and go in there with a smile and be willing to talk to people. You never know who you're gonna meet. But there are a few good positions I'm actually interested in and I'm going to apply for. And we'll see how that goes. See y'all later. Bye.